Hello everyone, welcome to our channel. This is Dr. Lokesh here. In this video, we are going to see how to make an intraoral periapical radiograph. In between the video, I have added simple but very useful tips by following which you will not go wrong in making an intraoral periapical radiograph. So watch this entire video for not missing those tips. If you find this video helpful, kindly like, share and consider subscribing to the channel. Let's see the basics first. In my previous video, I would have explained how to orient the film, that is the tube side with the embossing dot should face towards the tube and the label side with the tongue-like flap towards the tongue. The tooth to be radiographed should be exactly in the center of the film for all teeth except for the third molars. For anterior teeth, the film has to be placed vertically and the edge of the film should be 2 to 3 mm extending from the incisal plane. For posterior teeth, the film has to be placed horizontally and here the edge of the film should be 3 to 4 mm extending from the occlusal plane. The edge of the film should be parallel to the incisal and occlusal plane. First thing before we make an intraoral periapical radiograph is to give instructions to the patient. The patient should leave his or her neck, head, tongue, lips and cheeks free for us to place the film easily. Reassure the patient that since the edges of the radiographic film are sharp, there are chances that may cause pain, but not to worry as it is not going to harm the patient. While imaging the mandibular teeth, patient should leave the tongue and floor of the mouth completely free so that we can place the film adequately deep without harming the patient. Technically, we should use a film holder to reduce the exposure to the patient, but still in educational institutions, we generally ask the patient to hold the film due to time and resource constraints. So in that case, patient should always use the index finger. For right side imaging, patient should use the left hand index finger. And for left side imaging, patient should use the right hand index finger. Placing the film for upper anteriors. How much ever you want the edge to extend away from the incisal plane, measure and keep like this with your thumb finger. Now just take it inside the mouth and hit your thumbnails to the incisal plane, making sure the edge of the film is parallel to incisal plane. If you want to adjust the film, ask the patient to remove his fingers and then again adjust it and then put the fingers back. Placing the film for upper right posteriors, similarly place the thumb finger and hit the thumbnails to the occlusal plane, making sure that the edge of the film is parallel to the occlusal plane, and ask the patient to hold it with his index finger. Moving on to upper left posteriors, now we have to use our index finger for measuring and we have to just hit the index finger nails to the occlusal plane, ensuring the parallelism of the edge of the X-ray film to the occlusal plane. Next is for lower anteriors. Place the film like 2 to 3 mm of the film is extending away from the incisal plane. Now the important thing is patient has to raise his hand like this and then hold the film deep inside towards the tooth from top. By doing this, there will be no hindrance by the patient's hands to place the tube. For lower left posteriors, note that I am standing in the 9 o'clock position with my left hand to the left side of the patient, going around his head. I am placing the film inside with my right hand and then holding it with my left hand thumb on the top of the film until patient takes over to hold it. For lower right posteriors, note I am standing in the 7 o'clock position with both my right and left hands on the right side of the patient. Now I am placing the film inside with the right hand and holding it with my left hand index finger on top of the film until the patient takes over to hold the film. Next is the patient positioning. So patient should be seated upright and for the maxillary arch, the occlusal plane should be parallel to the floor and hence patient should slightly look down. Whereas for mandibular teeth, patient should look slightly up. The next step is tube placement. according to the recommended vertical angulation values. Here we are using the bisecting angle technique, as the paralleling technique can be used only with a film holder. So now we are ready to shoot the X-ray. Thanks for watching this video. If you found this video helpful, kindly like, share and consider subscribing the channel. Thank you.